there's a whole lot of heaven in the house. A whole lot of heaven in the house. A little bit of praise goes a long, long way. There's a whole lot of heaven in the house. There's a whole lot of heaven in the house. A whole lot of heaven in the house. A little bit of praise goes a long, long way.
How long have you been married?
We've been married 5.5 years. We were married in February the 13th of 2000.
And one. Yeah.
Yes. That's what I meant to say. I remember it was at the National Quartet Convention in the year 2000 that I got down on one knee in front of 20,000 people, and I looked at her and I said, Daisy, I'm a hunk. Will you marry me?
And I said, baby, you're a chunk, but yes, I will.
Twenty years ago, we were singing and everything was going well, and then my sister fell in love with Dean, my brother-in-law, and they got married and sis moved away. And I really didn't understand a lot about that at that time. But now I realize if Kim had never left singing with Tim and I, the opportunity would have never come for me to meet Taranda. And God had a great plan in my life to give me Taranda, the greatest wife that anybody would ever have. And I never realized God's plan, that the Lord would use my wife on August the 25th to save my life. And you all realize how sick that I've been, and we found out about the 1st of August that my wife was a perfect match to give me a kidney, and the doctors marveled of how well that they told us at the hospital that even if Taranda and I had been born twins, that we would not have matched any greater than we did. And it was just a miracle from God. But through it all, I've realized of how real that life is and how fragile that life really is. You can be well one day and you can be real sick the next. And I've talked to so many of you, and so many things are going on in your life. But I really believe that God wanted me to share with you tonight that no matter what situation that you have in your life, that God is not mad at you. Just because bad things happen, God isn't mad at you. God's just using those things to be faith builders in your life, so that each and every day you realize that the Lord and He alone is all that you need. Your hope is not in what Dr. Phil says or Oprah Winfrey says on TV. But the Bible says that our help and our hope is in the name of the Lord. And that's why that James wrote in the Word of God that when you and I are in trouble, to humble ourselves and pray. And the Lord said, I'll hear you. And I'll help you in your time of trouble. And tonight, I just wanted you to know that whatever is going on in your life that you're worried about, keep your faith and trust in God, and keep your little hand in His big hand, and realize that Jesus said, when thou passest through the waters, that I'll be with thee, and through the rivers, the Bible says, they'll not overflow thee. But when you walk in the fire, you shall not be burned, and neither shall the flame kindle upon you. As Jesus said, I am the Lord thy God, and I will help you in your time of trouble. So folks, keep your little hand in God's big hand, and you hold on.
Hold on, hold on. Oh,
this can be hard, that come by God's design, but you could see tomorrow with a view from heaven's throne. Every unexpected struggle has led you closer home. When God has another plan, walk on and just say yes. When God has another plan, be assured that He knows best. When all your dreams are shattered, rest in His sufficient grace. We don't have to